Welcome you all, dear students, here in this classes we will study about the waves, types of the waves and other properties of the wave. So here it is. In last we have progressive and discussed about progressive and standing waves. Now it's transverse waves and longitudinal waves. Longitudinal waves are, now here it is, the waves in which the particles of the medium vibrate perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave, and the waves in which particles of the medium vibrate parallel to the direction of propagation of the wave. You see, if you see, the waves are moving in this direction. In case of longitudinal waves, the particles are also moving along the same direction, but in case of transverse waves, the wave is moving to your left to right, but the particles are moving up and down. Particles of the medium are moving up and down. So here is the case where the particles of the medium are moving to and fro, right and left. But here is the case when you have dropped any ball at the surface of water, waves are moving away and towards you, but the ball is moving up and down. This shows that the particles of the medium are moving perpendicular. If the wave is moving from your left to right, the particles are moving perpendicular. This is the concept where the particles of medium are moving perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave. Waves are moving in this direction, particles are moving up and down. Example, I have given you a ball placed at the water. It is not moving right and left, it is moving up and down. So this is the concept of transverse waves, waves produced in water. But this is another concept. Sound waves are longitudinal in nature. Why? Because if the surface is moving in and out, the compression reflections are produced in the air in the same direction, and the particles of the mediums are also moving along the same direction. This is one of the best examples to understand about the longitudinal waves. So here is the transverse waves consist of crest and trough. This is basically, this one is trough, this one is crest. The point on the wave where the vibration of the particle is minimum below the mean position, that is called crest. The particle position of the particle above the mean position, where the maximum position vibration of the particle is, this is called crest. But in case of standing longitudinal waves, the compression and rarefactions are produced. High pressure area, particles away closer to each other. Low pressure area, rarefaction, particles away from each other. So this is the concept of the longitudinal waves. The distance between two consecutive crests or two consecutive troughs is called equal to half a wavelength. Here the distance between two consecutive compression or two rarefaction is equal to one of the wave, half of the wavelength. The transverse waves can propagate in solid and at the surface of the water only. But longitudinal waves can propagate in solid, liquids, as well as in gases, as I have given you an example of a sound in air. Sound waves are longitudinal in nature. Longitudinal waves cannot be polarized. Polarized mean they are moving only along the same direction, away from the source producing. So that's why they are not polarized. But electromagnetic waves can be polarized. Sunlight is one of the best example of electromagnetic waves, where there are infinite number of options for the waves to vibrate in up, down, right, left, and between each other. So that's why after polarization, we select the sum of the portion of the light and we reject the rest of the portion of the light. Transverse waves may or may not require medium for their propagation. May means they are like water. May not mean transverse waves, light waves are also transverse in nature. So they are not requiring any type of medium. Here it is. Water requires medium, while the electromagnetic waves do not require medium for their propagation. And electromagnetic waves are also transverse in nature. So generally, longitudinal waves require medium for their propagation. Here, medium is, and some cases it is not, for their propagation. For sound waves, longitudinal waves which cannot travel through the vacuum. These sound waves, there is no possibility of traveling a sound waves through the vacuum. So if you are standing at the surface of moon, two persons standing closer to each other will be unable to hear each other because sound, there is no medium, so that's why the sound waves are not traveling. So how are the people traveling for space in such places use communication by radio waves? Because radio waves are transparent in nature, they can move through the medium, through the place where there is no medium. So this is the concept of transverse wave. Water waves produced in stretch spring are the example of transverse wave. These are the examples of transverse wave. So sound waves, earthquake waves are the examples of longitudinal waves. So these are the some of the examples to understand what type of waves, transverse waves are, and what are the types of longitudinal waves. What is the difference between them? What will be the difference in case of crest to crest, trough to trough, or so on, rarefaction to compression, compression to rarefaction. So this is the concept. And this is the difference between the two waves. I thank you very much.